够人了。
It's past the time we have a quorum. Does any other member wish to ask questions? If not, I will deal with Mr. Albert Chen's 37A. Chairman, this is a motion under 37A. It's a simple request. Are we going to have division? The bell will be rung for 5 minutes, and then you will explain your motion. Ring the bell for 5 minutes. Well, it just occurred to me because it's related to works and $3 billion. It's very important. Well, sometimes, well, you remember in Tsinghua Bridge, it was a Korean company. They had the tender for the project, $4.7 billion. They won it, and however, for some reason, it's gone to a different contractor, and well, so there is a chance that it will be given to another company. Well, this is related to China State Construction. It's related to water containing lead in Kaiting Estate. I've read from some report that the parent company of China State Construction has been blacklisted by the World Bank. We are still looking into the relationship between this subsidiary and the parent company. We're talking about quality and public money. So before there is proof from this company that they have nothing to do with the mistake, they have nothing to do with excessive level of lead in water, the project should not be given to them. So I move this motion in accordance with Rule 37A of the rules of the FC. I move a motion in relation to Phase 3B of the Kaitek Development Area District Cooling System, since it involves a large amount of laying of pipes, and the fact that China State Construction was the contractor of Kaiting Estate, and they are now suspected to have committed serious mistake in their water supply works, and it affects public health. So this committee requests that before the China State Construction can prove that they have nothing to do with the mistake made in relation to Kaiting Estate, the administration should not sign any agreement with China State Construction in relation to this Phase 3B of Kaitek District Cooling System. I've considered this motion and it's related to the item under discussion. I will put this item to a vote that the committee agrees to dealing with Mr. Chen's motion moved under 37A of the FC procedures. Let me remind members that Mr. Albert Chen has moved a motion under 37A of FC procedure. You can see it on the screen, and in 5 minutes we will have to vote on this. You decide whether you support Mr. Chen's motion. Before I announce the result, members, please check your votes. Voting closes. Result displayed. 8 for, 24 against. Motion is negatived. We now move into well, I'm now going to put this item to a vote. Is it going to be a division? Yes. The bell will ring for 5 minutes. We are now discussing Mr. Albert Chen, Mr. Yong Kwok Hong. Let me remind you not to have a discussion among yourselves in the conference room. Do it outside. Well, not many members know what this bell is for. We are talking about PWSC Record 2015-16 number 29. This is about the Kaitak cooling, a district cooling system at the Kaitak development. It's a 45 CJ. Is to increase estimated project cost by $661 million. That is from $3.1459 billion to $3.752 billion.
现在开始表决。
So it's now time to vote. Before I announce the result, members, please check your vote. Time's up. Please indicate the results. 36 in favor, 0 objection, and so the item was approved. So item 7 for separate voting. Now we're going to deal with the PWSC 20151632. Sorry, members, please stay quiet. If you want to discuss, please do it outside the chamber. Now we're going to handle paper PWSC 2015-16-32. This is about upgrading 8 projects to Category A. Epic Chen asked the administration on the harbourfront enhancement and revitalization. The project of revitalization of Shingun River Promenade and the other 285RS project, officials responsible for that project to attend the meeting in order to answer your questions for the project 4540 and 285RS. We have with us Ms. Charmaine Wong Hoi Wen, Acting Deputy Director of Home Affairs, Mr. Martin Kwong Wai Chung, Chief Engineer, Home Affairs Department, Ms. Dennis Cheng Yuk King, Chief Leisure Manager of Leisure and Cultural Service Department, Anthony Lin Ping Wai, District Officer, Home Affairs Department, Ms. Cora Ho Lai Shun, District Officer, Home Affairs Department, Mr. Wong Wei Man, Deputy Project Manager, CEDD, Sha Tin District Council, Mr. Ho Hao Cheng. Time to have you the first round, 5 minutes. Thank you. I also like to thank the two district councils and the chairman, vice chairman of the two district councils, as well as the district officer to come. I know you're busy with a lot of livelihood matters. I don't know whether Friday night last week you were busy. I know you're busy with the work, and I hope that you can bring a good news to your district later on. I'm also an outline district councillor. Well, we've went through a good process from members moving the item, and also there is also a scoring system when the before the public consultation was held, and then the government department was involved in doing the actual design. I mean, the project went through the adequate consultation process and also the procedures. So I hope that other members could indeed approve this livelihood items as soon as possible. As a district councillor myself, since January 2012, when the policy came into place till now, we haven't yet been able to use the money. So I wonder whether this is a sign of a regression in administration efficiency. I think this project actually had been around for a long time. We should speed up our work. I want to ask a financial question for the outline island. The budget involved is $95 million. So if we cannot approve, or in the entire summer we can't approve this item, and we have to leave this item till after the summer recess, then would the price go up? And even if we approve the item today, well, the overall funding is $95 million. It was $100 million, and if the cost exceeds the budget, then what can we do? Who can answer this? Director. Thank you, Mr. Tang, for your question. Just then, you mentioned that the $100 million funding is the cap, and we do hope that we can also get additional funding, and that is in coming up with the estimate of the project, we use the money of the day prices as the basis. Therefore, we have already taken into consideration inflation. And secondly, Mr. Tang was concerned about why it had taken so long for this project to come to us. Well, we did have to do the preliminary work properly first, coming up with a tender and also the design, designating the scope of the works, and also we had to conduct the technical feasibility study. So we have to be firm about the technical feasibility and then come up with the details of the project. So after doing the preliminary work, then we could come up with a budget estimate, a more reliable estimate. So we are now quite confident that within the $100 million, the cost could be met. And there could be issue, however, with the commencement of the works. So we have reserved 10% of the construction cost for contingency purpose. So now, given all the preparations we have done, we believe that the project could be completed with the 100 million budget. So if we cannot get the funding approval before the summer recess, what will happen? We do hope that today, we can get the finance committee's approval for the funding request, and then we can start inviting tenders, and we then think that we can finish the project with the cost expected. So you haven't started inviting tenders? Yes, we haven't started that yet. We need to get finance committee's approval first. Next one, Chen Jichun, first round, 5 minutes. Thank you, Chairman. Please note that this is a $100 million project for District Council. You know, you said that our progress of vetting projects has been slow. But for some items, say in Kwai Chung, we did handle that. So, and for some other projects, they haven't even been dealt with at the public works committee stage. In this paper, there are initially 10 items in the paper, but we extracted 2 items, including the that is, there are 2 items that will be voted on separately. But I don't know why, during the Public Works Committee stage, those 2 items were taken out and said they would find another time to submit those 2 earlier items to us. But even, actually, no matter what, we would vote on them before the summer recess. We would not actually block the government's plan to increase civil servants' pay. And then say, they would say that we are obstructing the entire process. Chen Jichun, please focus on this item. Okay, and now I'm going to focus on the revitalization of Xingmen River Promenade plan. So maybe they can answer my questions on it first. So I just want you to stay on course. Yes, okay, on this, on the revitalization of Xingmen River Promenade. Leung Go Hong, can you not disturb him, please? Can you not cause any disturbances, please? Well, Annex 9, the lighting system, does it use LED bulbs or energy-saving bulbs? Because experts have said that LED bulbs would emit blue ray, which is very bright, but when it's used for a long time, and if someone is exposed to it for a long time, then the retina could be harmed. And so they're worried that using these light bulbs could affect people's vision. Experts have warned that long-term exposure to LED bulb could cause tiredness in the eyes, and ultraviolet ray cause also could affect the health. European Union points that 1 out of 3 people would feel uncomfortable when exposed to the LED bulbs. Can you focus on the question? Yes, you know, the public is very concerned about its health, like the safety of drinking water and so forth. So how about the risk? Has the administration assessed the risk of being exposed to unhealthy light? Mr. Wong, we will use LED lighting, but all the lighting will be shown on the buildings. There won't be any human contact or direct exposure to the light, LED light. It will be reflections only if they're to be exposed to the light. So we have done our assessment and we think that the impact was very minimal. Chin Chi Chin, well, you made it very clear now that you have done the assessment that people would not be directly exposed to the light, because so if there's direct exposure, then they could be exposed to the risk, right? Yes, is that right? Mr. Wong, yes, let me reiterate, all the lighting will face the bridge. So the public would not be in direct exposure to the light. Have you also assessed the lighting system, whether it would cause nuisance to people living on both sides of the Xingmen River, that is the light pollution? Well, all of our lighting, as I said, will be to the direction of buildings, and the brightness level is relatively low, and we do use soft colors. So our assessment has shown that it would not cause any, it would cause very, very minimal nuisance to nearby residents. I'd like to ask the administration, any response from the administration? You know, on my point about why extracting those two other items from today's agenda. Yeah, the item in Jinwan, Sai Lau Kok, and Sha Tin, Tai Wai, Nola. Director, can you answer that? My understanding is that when the PWSC asked that the two items should be voted on separately, then these two items you mentioned will need to put on the waiting list and queue up again if they were to be voted on separately. Okay, so can you wait till the second round? Are you asking about the voting arrangement for today? Well, there are eight other items that have not been extracted, right? Or do we have 2 plus 7 or 8? We are talking about two items here, the 4, 5. So you've extracted 4, 5, 4, 5, 0, and 2, 8, 5, RS. And now we're going to vote on PWSC 15, 16, 32. Altogether, there are about 8 or 10 items, and you've extracted 2 items. So if we vote down this paper, then that means all the 8 projects will be voted down. Is that right? And if we agree, then we agree with them all. Is that right? Yes. Because this is a bunch. The whole paper involves a bunch of projects. And at the PWSC stage, we discussed it as in one paper. But then later on, they want to extract 2 items for separate voting, and that's what we are faced with. When the time comes for voting, well, I won't take up your time, but let me explain to you that when we vote, we will be voting PWSC 2015-16-32. We will be voting on that paper. Leung Kwok Hong, first round, 5 minutes. Just then, I heard his point about LED. Leung Kwok Hong, would you mind? I can't hear very well. Okay. I heard your point about LED. I found it funny. You said that the LED lighting would be facing the bridge, so it should not affect people. But I found it funny. How about pedestrians? If the pedestrians look in the direction of the lighting, then what will happen? Say, let him answer you, please. Mr. Wong? When lighting will be shown on the bridge, that is, it will be shown from the bottom of the bridge to the top of the bridge. So pedestrians would not come into direct contact with the lighting. So because the lighting or the lights or the pole lampposts would not be put right on the bridge, so the pedestrians would not be actually in direct exposure to the light. Yes, if you're walking on the bridge, you would not be able to look into the lighting. You have to jump into the river, and then if you jump into the river, you will see the lighting, the lights. So is the area under the bridge a restricted area? I've never been there myself. This is just my guess, Mr. Wong. Well, you can have rowing under the bridge, but you'll be on the boat if you're rowing. So normally speaking, you would not be looking right at the light, because the light will be cast on the surface of the bridge. So in other words, you're saying that people would not be in direct contact with the light. You can find me. I can take you around the area. I live in Shantin. Okay, but I do have doubts. But Anthony Jung is the same with Anthony Jung. Well, if you ask him, how many prefabricated units are there? And he said a small quantity, and then it was found that there were a lot more. Okay, well, but anyway, I'll take your word for it. In choosing the lighting equipment, what criteria did you use? What is so special about LED lighting besides its potential harm? Is it because it's advanced technology, or is it because you have a lot of LED lighting in stock that hasn't been used? I think our main consideration is energy conservation. We want to reduce the amount of energy consumed, and we also want to allow for a combination of different colors so that there can be different lighting effects created at different times. Dong Kwang Hong, Justin Chen Chi Chin pointed out to you the harm of LED lighting. Have you assessed the impact at all besides people might go blind?
Can we use other types of lighting? As Ray Chan said, he's concerned whether the lights will be cast on passers-by. My answer is that unless you climb to a very high position, you are unlikely to see those lights. I think the scenario Ray Chan suggested would not exist. Why did you choose to use LED lights instead of other types of lights? First of all, we want to save power. And second, we are able to come up with different light effects. Why don't you use energy-saving bulbs? Which of them is more energy-saving? Energy-saving bulbs or LED bulbs? I think the thing is that we can come up with different effects with LED bulbs. We can use different colors, and we can come up with different themes at different times. For example, during festivals, we can show different themes. How many colors can you come up with for energy-saving bulbs? The design would be more complicated. It's easier with LED bulbs. Mr. Leung Kwok Hong, have you done any comparison? Have you come up with any comparison in the paper to show us that you have considered the alternative? We have not done such assessment because LED bulbs can satisfy our requirements. Mr. Albert Chen, first round, 5 minutes. I wanted to ask about Mui Wo, but since we are talking about LED bulbs, given the same luminosity, you have more options with LED bulbs and they would consume less power. They would also be more compact, right? I don't have specific data on hand to show these such comparison, but in general, LED bulbs can satisfy our requirements under our budget. as I know, given the same volume, given the same brightness level, LED bulbs would be smaller, right? And given the same brightness, LED bulbs would be more energy saving than energy saving bulbs. Mr. Wong? I am not an expert in this field, but in terms of design, we do have experts who can come up with an appropriate judgment, and we find the decision appropriate. But I cannot explain the specifics since I'm not an expert. Can you go back to the question about Mui Wo? I have a question about the Silver Mine Bay Beach. I live nearby and I go there very often. I'm very familiar with the surroundings. We are talking about two facilities. First of all, there's a music festival in Mui Wo every year. It's rather successful, and it attracts thousands of visitors every year. Would this new facility affect the music festival? Who can answer this question? Thank you very much for the question. The music festival is one of the measures to revitalize Silver Mine Bay Beach. It's a very popular beach, and we have a number of large-scale events, for example, canoe events, dragon boat races, beach volleyball, etc. If you visit there often, you would know that there are lots of beach volleyball games going on. And it's also a popular spot for barbecues. Since the facilities are rather old, we want to revitalize them, together with other works to revitalize Mui Wo. Hopefully we can achieve some synergy. And through the revitalization, we can provide a better platform for the music festival. And we will have a storeroom to store props and equipment for the music festival. We don't have a lot of facilities at Mui Wo at the moment. If we are able to revitalize Silver Mine Bay Beach, it's a very natural setting. It's a great spot for sun and beach. From the plan, I cannot see the correlation between the revitalization scheme and the music festival. During every year, a stage and audiovisual equipment must be set up for the festival, so the link is not very obvious. And I'm concerned with the beach volleyball games as well. Years ago, I proposed the government to set up a training camp at Changsha. And the answer was that it was not suitable, and they came up with a beach volleyball court in Silver Mine Bay Beach, and I wasn't very satisfied with this arrangement. I think we should have multiple volleyball courts in order to build a culture and create a selling point for the area. If possible, I think we should come up with more beach volleyball courts at the beach. I'll treat this as a second round. Please go on. So my question is, which facilities are catered for the music festival? Second round, 3 minutes. Chairman, can I answer the question? As I said, the revitalization of Silver Mine Bay Beach is not just for the music festival. If we are to set up a stage, we have to deal with regulations on the beach and seabeds, so on. So our approach is to set up temporary stages for different events. If LegCo says we are able to amend the regulations, then of course we would welcome the suggestion. For other sports facilities, I think we'll leave it to the relevant departments. Of course, we want to cater for different sports and activities at beaches. You know, we want to cater other events like sand building, so on. But we have to live with the site and technical restrictions. And I want to stress that the revitalization scheme doesn't aim to only serve the music festival. There are a lot of events going on at the beach every year. Can anyone answer the question on the beach volleyball courts? Why can't we have more courts? Apparently, no facilities are being catered for the festival, and yet we are spending more than $50 million. One of the challenges of the festival is the power supply. Under this enhancement scheme, would the electricity supply system be enhanced in order to solve this problem? Every year, they have to spend a lot of money on power. If you are able to have a system in place, they can save a lot of money. Ms. Lee, thank you very much. On the power supply system, every year there are a lot of major events at the Silvermine Bay Beach. So under our project, we would introduce outdoor power supplies to facilitate such events. For events organized by LCSD or the Home Affairs Bureau, then they won't need substantial AV equipment. Would those equipment be enough for a large-scale music festival, or would they have to make extra connections upon application? As we designed the outdoor power supply system, we considered the big events that would take place at the beach, including AV equipment. Can you tell us increase in amounts of electricity? Can you share those figures with us later? Mr. Lam Kwok Hong, second round, 3 minutes. I want to talk about the revitalization of Sheng Mun River Promenade. And I asked about LED lights. Now I want to know about something else. How long would the lighting system be turned on every day? And how much support is needed? What's the total energy consumption at the three bridges? What's the total carbon emission? Have you done such calculations? Who can answer this question? Mr. Ho, on the electricity consumption. I would leave that to Mr. Wong. Let me address the first question on the use of lighting system. They are not necessarily turned on every day. In the last 30 years, during winter, we have always had festive lights. And we have been using more and more lights in recent years, and we will have some lighting decorations at the bridges during those times. We would turn them on at night for short periods of time. The electricity consumption should be limited. I think Mr. Wong can tell us more about the actual consumption. So on. According to our estimation, if we turn on all the lights, of course, they might not find necessarily to turn on the lights every night. The bridges differ in size. The Lake Yun Bridge, if we turn on the lights for 3 hours every night, we would have to spend about $8. For the two larger bridges, it would cost $30 to $40, assuming we turn on the lights for 3 hours per night. What about the carbon emission? Do you have such figures? I have figures on wattage, but not the carbon emission. Mr. Ho said that $50 million was secured for the Sheng Mun River Promenade for festive lights. The lights wouldn't be turned on every night, is that correct? Mr. Ho? This project costs $50-odd million. As the paper said, it consists of several parts. The lightings are only one part. We would also deal with the issues like display enhancement of pedestrian bridge and so on. Mr. Raymond Wong, first round, 5 minutes. I want to talk about the Sheng Mun River Promenade near Sha Tin Town Centre, and several $50 million will be spent on the festive lightings, and there will be new display signs. So what's actually the goal? What is it that you want to achieve? The Sheng Mun River reminds us of other rivers in the mainland and other countries, but what they're doing is something we should learn. The EA panel visited Korea for a visit. We visited the a village in Seoul, as well as Taipei and Kaohsiung in Taiwan. Those rivers are very similar to Sheng Mun River, but when you compare these rivers, you would doubt whether Sheng Mun River is really a recreational space for our people. Can Sheng Mun River provide enjoyment for the public? The river in Kaohsiung used to be very stinky, and the municipal government spent a lot of money to enhance the river. If you visit Kaohsiung, you can take a boat trip. And there are a number of riverside kiosks, and everyone can put up a kiosk. They won't have to pay any rents. As long as you have products or handicrafts, you can put up a kiosk. This is something we can learn from. So in the revitalization of Sheng Mun River, I think there's a lot we can learn from our neighbors. Right now, you're only putting up lights and signs, and you're going to spend, you know, dozens of millions. So what's the point? We have reps from the district council. I'd like them to give their views. Mr. Ho, have you had any discussions among yourself? Have you learned from Kaohsiung, Taipei, and Seoul? Have you seen what they're doing? Mr. Ho, I agree with Mr. Raymond Wong. Sheng Mun River is an icon of Sha Tin. I've served the district council for 20 years, and during this period, we talked a lot about revitalizing and enhancing Sheng Mun River. This is an opportunity for us. So we have done our best in revitalizing Sheng Mun River. over the course of discussion among ourselves, we did consider these good examples from our neighbors. But we can only do what we can with our resources. The government put in efforts to enhance water quality in the past, and this time we want to enhance the Xingmun River Promenade, especially the section near Sha Tin Town Center. And we are doing it for the enjoyment of the entire Hong Kong public. And our work has been smooth so far. And I think this would benefit both Sha Tin residents and the entire Hong Kong public, Mr. Raymond Wong. We talked about Taipei, Kaohsiung, and Seoul. Their rivers are very similar as Xingmun. Before the revitalization, I think, can you wait for the next round, please? Mr. Ray Chen. Excuse me, Mr. Loi Kwok. 1 minute, 5 minutes. Right now, for the revitalization of Xingmun River Promenade near Sha Tin Town Center, I'm fully supportive. I spent 18 years at Tsing Wan Road working adjacent to the Nala. If we can exploit the space above the NOLA, it can be put into a lot of uses to bring convenience to the district. Under the key projects of the Sha Tin District Council, there have been multiple discussions, and I've served Sha Tin District Council for more than 10 years. So I know how hard it is to reach a consensus among the community. And I'll surely support this project, which is beneficial to Sha Tin. As I mentioned in PWSC, I've repeated my view, so I don't intend to repeat myself again. I think we should support something that the District Council has already agreed on. Mr. Ray Chan, second round, 3 minutes. I asked about the impacts of LED bulbs on human beings.
And the administration said that it would only point towards the body of the bridge and not at people. I was asking about effect on eyesight, and I've also mentioned about on skin. In the information enclosure, it seems from the information there that is the lights don't shine on the passageway. So what illumination is there for the passageway, and will there be a difference in calculation of the strength of lighting there for pedestrian lighting system? It will be the same as just street lights you see in the street. When designing lighting, the consultant has taken into account all existing street lighting. I do not hear you clearly. What is the number of days over the year when it will be on? I was going to ask about depreciation. Do you have any plans to ensure that when the lights when the lights break, you have any environmental friendly way to dispose of them? We have yet to decide on the hours of when the light will be switched on. That depends on the future discussion, but as I've reported previously, there is traditional festive lighting in Shaoxing near Christmas, Chinese New Year. They will be on for longer hours. In that case, well, do they have information about their lifespan, in terms of number of hours for these light bulbs, and any environmental friendly measures to dispose of them? Yes, we do have the information. You see that they have been taken into account as recurrent expenses in relation to the replacements, and we will follow established procedure to deal with disposal. Next round, perhaps. Mr. Wong Kok King, first round, first time, 5 minutes. Thank you. I don't need all my 5 minutes. I was a former anti-West legislator. I support strongly the proposal related to the island. In Muiwo, the silver mine Bay Beach is an item that has been discussed for a very long time. Residents strongly ask for it, and island's residents would like the administration to give them more resources to revitalize Muiwo so that more business opportunities can be created. You've been to many different places. You've got the support of district councils, and there has been many rounds of discussions in LegCo. There shouldn't be any problem, but I believe you understand that there is filibustering in the finance committee, so that the last item, the ITB, won't get funding support because there won't be any time to discuss it. And your item is being used to further their aim. It's being sacrificed. These questions have been repeated many times, and of course it's their right to ask questions, and there is nothing I can do. To show my support, as a former legislator from NT-West, I ought to express my support. And in relation to the Shaoxing project, NT East, I support it too, because it's a reasonable request, and there has been many discussions and in the district council, and is supported. I hope filibustering councillors will quit while they're ahead. Don't put the chairman and the district officer in a difficult position. Quit while you're ahead. I hope the project will be endorsed ASAP. I don't need any answers. Can you say that, can you ask them not to put me in a difficult position as well? Of course. Raymond Wong, well, you have to talk to CY Leung, Wong Kwok King. Chairman, ask Wong Kwok King to talk to CY Leung, because, well, there was a request to add 28 hours of meeting, and you acceded to it. Don't talk to him, talk to me. It's the duty of legislators to monitor the government. 689 wants a war. What loss do I have? I'll be sitting here for over 20 hours. It's no trouble to me. troubles caused to you all. You don't have to be here for 20 hours. I do. Yes, you're right. You have the most difficult time. That's why you have to scold CY Leung. He's a wretched guy. You have any questions? Of course I do. I ask questions of the district council and I have some questions for the administration. Now, this is just the section near Sha Tin Town Centre. Xingmen River is a resource. It belongs to Hong Kong. I mentioned about Taiwan, Kaohsiung. I do think it has a very high reference of value. The river has been a nearby river has been diverted. It's now very beautiful, but when I was a kid, when I was studying there, it was smelly. And now you can see river cruise, and there is space for creative industry to flourish there. There's no use for you to spend tens of millions of dollars there. So I want to ask the government, have you taken into consideration the approach of Kaohsiung? Because there, Riverside is very beautiful. Thank you. We have kept that in mind. Back in 2009, the Sha Tin DC engaged the Kadoorie Research Center and the CUHK to explore measures to beautify the Xingmen River. There are different sections, Sha Tin and Taiwai as well, and Xingmen. We will continue with monitoring the water quality. Since 2008, there has been a lot of minor works. So far, 300 or so to beautify the Xingmen River and the two sides. Apart from the signature, using the signature project, we have done some studies and will continue to do so about a live water body. And that include whether to increase the water culture of water-friendly culture of Xingmen River. In the middle of this year, we have some new plans about the structure along the river, and we'll continue to work on it. Mr. Leung Kwok Hung. According to your the information there, well, there will be lighting along the passageway. And you use energy-saving bulb. So I won't say that you are lying, but you have been economical with the truth. I know that everything is just verbal. Let me ask something Wong Kwok Hing has asked. You said that the power supply to the beach will be increased, and I asked you what is the capacity. You said you don't know. Well, maybe in the future the beach music festival will be an attraction for local people. So for a beach music festival, you will need electricity and also lighting for the sound system, for lighting. Have you done any studies to make sure that you have sufficient capacity to support the festival, Mr. Wong? You don't know? Oh, no, it's not under my purview. Mr. Lee, please answer. Thank you. As I said, that the work when looking at the work, we have looked into energy consumption in for similar activities in nearby areas in our design. When we were seeking views from the district council, there was a special request made, and we have taken that into account to provide special power supply facilities. As Mr. Chen said, that in the past, when these large-scale activities were organized, they had to do their best to try to get sufficient power supply. It's not ideal in terms of safety. And that's why we have put in place facilities for the outdoor facilities. There is not much difference between this one and other outdoor power supply facilities. It's just that there is no need to have a lot of extension because it's quite close to the power supply point. Mr. Lee, I'm afraid you cannot answer how much more power supply is involved. Well, we used to talk about ampere, and now you use kilowatt hour. If you don't know, just say you don't know. Just say that we have sufficient power supply for the music festival. Mr. Lee? In the past, it's about 100 to 200 ampere. We're still working on the detailed design. So when it comes to the actual power supply, we will take into account the actual demand or need. But if you don't know, then just say you don't know. It's very simple. Do you know how much more? How much the increase will be. You've taken us around the, you've beaten about the bush, and members will continue to ask questions. We have another session at 6:45, which will last until 8:45. I don't mind if you stay here to accompany me, but if I've already told you, if you don't know, just say you don't know. So you don't know how much the increase will be, right? We have yet to set the level of supply. You now want a sum of money to increase the supply capacity. Can you tell me how much if the Hong Kong Electric, I don't know whether it's Hong Kong Electric or the China Light and Power, to increase the supply capacity, how much more it will cost? Did they not tell you? I don't have the information with me. Mr. James Toh, first round, 5 minutes. My concern is management of a venue. Which venue? Muiwa? I want to know about legal basis of the management of the venue. Say, for example, for the beach. So are they going to use the bylaws of the LCSD or some other organizations? and then the organization will make its own bylaws. We're talking about public money. So with these additions, will there be new organizations managing it? Say, for example, for the Meifu Neighborhood Center, is it owned by an NGO? Will that NGO compile a code of practice, say, for example, about the hire of the venue? Well, can you give me more information about, say, for example, the bylaws of the LCSD or bylaws of other organizations or code? The Silver Mine Bay Beach is under the purview of the LCSD. After beautification, it will still remain in the purview of the LCSD. And every time there is an activity, it's subject to the approval of the LCSD. So it's covered by the bylaw of the LCSD, right? My understanding is yes. If it takes more space than under the purview of the LCSD, then we need the approval of the district office. We're talking about within the scope of the project under discussion. Is it covered entirely by the bylaws of LCSD? Yes. What about others? Will there be some that is managed by a specific organization and they have their own code or regulations? That is different from other areas. What do you mean? You mean money is spent to improve the facilities of the LCSD? No, we spend some money on a venue and it is managed by an organization and the rules are very restrictive, say for example, members only. Please put your questions in simple terms. So money is to be spent on Weiwo. Is it entirely within the purview of the LCSD? Am I right? Any other managing organizations? They've already answered you. It's entirely within the purview of the LCSD. What about the others? Anyone that is managed by another organization with a different set of rules? And what are they? I think out of the eight, the only one that involves an NGO collaborator will be the Shumshoupo Meifu Neighborhood Activity Center. Yanoi Tong was the collaborator. The district office will sign a memorandum of understanding and a service agreement with Yanoi Tong. There will also be a leasing agreement to regulate the use of the center. It's a project of the district council, and there will be a special committee monitoring the progress of this project and also future management. So it's owned by Yanoi Tong, but when it comes to management of the venue, it will be decided by the subcommittee of the district council.
It's a three-party committee with district council, Yanoi Tong, and the district office. Claudia Mo, 5 minutes first round. Chairman, I'd like to follow up on the Muiko Beach project, the Silver Mine Bay Beach. My understanding is that it does not include a landscape garden costing $10 million. I may have missed it. What is design like? Because at the Complaints Division, a number of residents from the New Territories Outlying Islands were concerned about particular plant species. They worried that the endangered species had been all felled.
警方、漁護署、海關
The Customs Department and the AFCD said that all these rare plant species were smuggled into China. The incense tree. So, my impression is that, is it like Disney? That the trees, the shrubs were indeed affected, and then in place of them were tulips or other figures imported from outside of Hong Kong. Do we have our own local nice, you know, homegrown landscape or species that can be featured there? Because I was looking at the paper, I wanted to find out about the design for the landscape garden that is said to be included. But I couldn't find any descriptions. Yeah, thank you, Chairman, Ms. Mo. The design, my impression is there wouldn't be any landscape design. You may be talking about the viewing deck. On the viewing deck, it will be designed in such a way that audience could go up there to enjoy a good view of activities. And also, on usual days, it can be used as a platform for people to exercise, doing aerobic exercise. So there won't be any artificial designs there or installations, but there will be decorations that would fit in with the surrounding views and the beach view. And the barbecue pit will be better designed, and also there'll be more pits, and so people can sit around the fire and enjoy the time together. I don't think we have anything like the landscape design, though, as you mentioned. Do you think that the viewing deck will have nothing to do with landscaping? It's just an empty space, is it? It's my understanding that there will be a landscape design? Yes, it is sort of a wasteland now, where the viewing deck will be built. We often collect a lot of rubbish from the beach, and we now have created a platform surrounded by like sculptures, so that people, when they are there, they will feel like exercising there. So the deck will be in harmony with the surrounding environment. So if it's nothing to do with landscaping, then the section full of rubbish, it will be... So it's still too early for us to talk about the design then? Well, if we are to have the revitalization project, of course, we need to come up with a design. And the design plan has been released. Yeah, maybe I've missed that. But my feeling is that you use wordings related to landscape. That's in my mind. So you wouldn't actually feature any plants there? The viewing deck is elevated, right? If you want to grow plants there or have decorations there, I'm sure you can do that. You can have some display of big potted plants, is that right? So is that just my own misunderstanding that there will be such features, Chairman? All along, we've been talking about the viewing deck. As for the wordings in the paper, I don't quite get what you're referring to. Whether, as you said, there's to be a landscaped design? I think to help you, I think she's referring to PWSC 2015-16-32, Enclosure 3, Paragraph 9. In Item F, there is this mention of external works and soft landscape with a cost of $10.6 million. Can anyone else from the administration answer it? Not necessarily have to be the chairman or vice chairman. Mr. Lee, you raise your hand. Yes. I think, as mentioned in the paper, the entire works would involve removal of a small number of trees and replanting of some trees. The cost involved here is related to the removal and replanting of trees. And for the viewing deck at the beach, it is not meant to be a landscaped project. So the $10.6 million about external works and soft landscape, what is exactly about? You mentioned felling trees and planting trees. Are you going to fell incense trees and replant incense trees elsewhere?
Thank you, Chief. Liang
Kuo-hong. Mr. Lee. Well, what we're going to remove, the trees concerned are not endangered species, neither are they incense trees. Will you replant some incense trees elsewhere then? Well, they won't be included in the plants to be grown elsewhere. Next one is James Toh, second round, 3 minutes. Chairman, I was asking about the Shantin, the Nuller, that's supposed to be in Shantin, it's supposed to be a football pitch. We're talking about having something above the NOLA. After it's done, would it be managed by LCSD or who? Director, are you talking about the Shantin project? Yes. The NOLA, maybe the officer can answer, district councilor. Yes, even though the Shantin NOLA is not the project in this paper, included in this paper, but as we explained last time, in our paper submitted last time, the future management of that project will be the work of LCSD. If I remember correctly, James Toh was asking about, besides the Yang Oi Tong project, the others will be run by LCSD. No, of the 8 items, only one item involves non-governmental organization. That's the one in the project in Sham Shui Po. The rest will involve government departments, i.e. they're managed by various government departments. So we are going to, that means, take away one LCSD site and then gazette according to the bylaw. So you're asking whether there's money used to create a new site? Well, we're talking about a deck of land. Does it mean that in the future it will be run by LCSD, but it will be turned into a playground instead? That is all the site bookings, all the activities to be held there will be run by LCSD, Chairman? Yes. I think Mr. Toh was asking about another project, the decking of Tai Wai Nona in Shatin, the establishment of a multipurpose deck. Yes, that will be an area to be run by LCSD. And the approval of use of the space there will be run by LCSD. But this is an extracted item. It's not on today's agenda. Yes, it's in the paper, but then it's extracted, so we're not supposed to deal with it today. Next one is Albert Chan, third round, 2 minutes. Chairman, I said that I would support the item in principle, but I want to see a better design so that important activities can be accommodated for example, the beach concerts. Well, in enclosure 3, you can see the a simple plan showing what it will look like after the improvement works. One facility, major facility, is the viewing deck on the beach. You know that music parties or concerts on the Muiwol Beach has become a sort of a landmark activity in Hong Kong. So if you design the viewing deck in such a way that in the future it can be the dance floor for the beach concerts or beach music shows, then it'd be good. So indeed, you can see the original idea for the deck is that it will look the other way, or facing in the direction. But if there's proper lighting, I'm sure the money will be even better spent. I know that this is just a preliminary plan. I don't know whether the district office and the district council, together with the LCSD, could you consider, you know, further enhancing the design, beautifying the design so that the facilities would be used for wide range of purposes and meet the needs better. Thank you. Yeah, your suggestion is very good. It can help save money, but when the music concert is on, or festival is on, the beach will be full of people. And the deck is right at the entrance of the beach. If you turn it into a dance floor or stage, then, you know, and also right in front of it are residential units. So we do need to move the deck elsewhere so that it's built when the music festival is on. I do appreciate your comment for the landmark event. There will be some other mini stages, so when the music festival is on, the deck will be one of the mini stages on the spot, and on normal days it can be used as a platform on which people exercise, so it can serve various purposes. Chen Qichun, third round, 2 minutes. Yes, on the revitalization of Xingwen River project, enclosure 9, you can see the breakdown of the costs. Community engagement and publicity cost $2 million. In comparison with other projects, like the Silver Mine Bay project, where $1 million is reserved for community engagement and publicity. So, do you arrive at such figures according to a formula or due to other considerations? Because you are, of course, if you are dedicating up to $100 million for an event that nobody is aware of, then that would be you know, money not well spent. But for the Xingwen River lighting, you know, if nobody knows about the special lighting system, then that would be a waste of money. So do you need to spend up to $2 million on publicity? In comparison with other projects, do you have any indicators or guidelines on, you know, how much money to use for community engagement and publicity? And the $2 million, do you know how this money will be used? What will it be spent on? On what sorts of activities? Dragon dance or what? Ms. Ho? Yeah, on the Xingwen River project, we're very pleased to get the sponsorship from the Hong Kong Jockey Club, in that we don't expect to just do publicity, but actually we want to involve the public. Therefore, at the District Council, well, in the past, there have been various activities along Xingwen River. So we want not just users, but the Jockey Club or students, you know, can be involved, not just, you know, we won't be just having publicity activities, but we want to have educational or other activities, so therefore we reserve a budget of $2 million to try to strike a balance in organizing all sorts of events. Is the Hong Kong Jockey Club giving you extra money? Yes, for the entire project, if you refer to the paper, you see that for the entire project in Shanghai, Jockey Club has donated up altogether $14 million. And it will proportionally provide a proportional amount for publicity purpose. So that is, of the $100 million, Jockey Club will shoulder $14 million. So mathematically speaking, we will be offering a ratio of 2 to 5 in terms of their and our contribution. Okay, next one is Liang Kuo-hong. Well, you want, okay, I can give my time to Claudia Mo. Well, of course, I will support the Meifu project. How can you not support it? You know, can you not support having a, you know, neighborhood activity center, you know, that can be used as a community center? I know Meifu has its own community center now, but until last year, when I met with some Meifu residents in Chengsha Wan, they said something to me that a very active NGO in Meifu is still worried that this particular item put before us is too political, because they feel that Yan Oi Tong is actually an organization comprising pro-establishment and Beijing figures. So they're worried that, you know, in your reply to James To's question, an official said that you would sign service agreements with Yan Oi Tong, the NGO, and the Meifu residents, well, they don't even have to quote the concern from that community group, Ka Ching. They share with us their worry already. And at our Home Affairs panel, we discussed already that there are existing district councillors who used to be chairman of Yan Oi Tong. And they said that, well, no. When they made an application, made applications for activities, and is all handled properly, but residents are still worried. So my question is, in the future, the activities center, when it's built, would it be managed, run, or for the purpose of pro-establishment figures? And when Meifu residents make applications for activities to be held there, will there be a political sort of screening? Say, if we're not friends with the Yan Oi Tong, would they be given a chance to use the place? Or, you know, would they be told that, well, the place is full already, bookings are full, or that you would not qualify, and so forth? So this is the concern, worry of the residents in Meifu. I know here this is the finance committee, but if they are, well, they are residents with such thinking. So what would you say to them to ease their worries?
I'd like to remind members that if you have only 3 minutes and you use it up, then there's no time for the administration to respond. The paper is rather special in nature, so perhaps you have not been following it very clearly. One of the items is about Meifu, but the paper we are going to vote on today, number 32, consists on many different items, and we only pinpointed two of the items for questions. Meifu is not within one of those chosen items. Instead of spending another 3 minutes to ask about political censorship, perhaps we will, I'll allow the administration to respond. As the chairman said, I'd like to stress a few points. When the NGOs are chosen, they are being chosen in a transparent manner. As we said, after securing the NGOs, the district councils will sign MOUs and service agreements with the relevant NGOs, and they have to report to the district council regularly. If Ms. Mo has such concerns, I can relay your views to the district councils. Mr. Lung Hong, fourth round, 1 minute. You have a minute only. You're spending $10 million on a landscape deck, but a beach is for swimming. Are you going to spend some money on changing rooms and lockers or shower facilities? You know, I'm sure swimmers won't want their possessions to be stolen. Can you give them some answer to respond? How much money have you spent apart from the deck? Do you have any money for other facilities like lockers? For the entire revitalization project, we spent a lot of resources on enlarging the showers, facilities, and toilets. This is an answer to the needs of many big events. How much money are you going to spend? Please wait for the next round. Mr. Albert Chen, fourth round, 1 minute. In principle, I support the proposal, but I do have some reservations on the viewing deck. If the deck has important uses, for instance, if it can be used as a main stage of the music festival, then it's worthwhile. But when you look at the designs, the viewing deck actually obstructs the view of the Muiwo beach. Right now, we have a vast stretch of sand, but it's being obstructed by this new deck. It really affects the overall view. Sometimes district councils would come up with very big ideas, but they might not be the best. Mr. Leung Kwok Hong, fifth round, 1 minute. My question is, how many shower compartments and lockers will you provide? Commissioner, thank you very much. Under this project, we will increase the number of male compartments from 7 to 12, and we'll also have more toilets for shower compartments. We'll increase the number from 1 to 4, and we will for changing rooms, will increase from 9 to 12, and the number of female toilets will increase from 9 to 13. We'll increase the number of wash basins from 10 to 12, and the shower facilities would increase from 1 to 4, and for female changing rooms from 7 to 12. We will introduce baby changing rooms, accessible toilets, and so on. Ms. Claudia Mo, third round, 2 minutes. Chairman, I'd like to follow up on the toilets. I'm a bit concerned that the arrangement is not realistic. We've been talking about it for 3 or 4 years. For public and private toilets, the ratios are wrong or imbalanced. You said that for male toilets, you will increase from 7 to 12, and for female toilets, 9 to 13. You have not responded to public concerns on the number of or ratio of male and female toilet cubicles. Thank you very much for the question. When we considered the ratio of male and female changing room and toilet cubicles, we considered the area available for changing rooms. For female changing cubicles, we increased it from 7 to 12. For male cubicles, we increased from 9 to 11. Or a 20% increase. So we considered the demand and needs for male and female cubicles, and we're trying to satisfy the demand. he did not address the question of changing rooms and toilet cubicles. Changing rooms are important because some swimmers are often muddy. Ms. Mo, I think he answered your question even though you might not like it. You can admit that you don't like his answer, but he did indeed give an answer. Mr. Ray Chan, fourth round, 2 minutes, please. I'd like to follow up on the community engagement, the $2 million spent for the Sha Tin project. He said the Jockey Club donated $40 million. This is something I don't understand. I don't care how much they donated, but they should not come here for the funds. On the other hand, if they donated $40 million, then you won't have to pay so much for community engagement. You should ask for less money here. He said we should, if we give $100 million, then on proportion, the Hong Kong Jockey Club would give $40 million. This is proportional. The speaker's off the microphone. He said what the $2 million is for. He didn't say whether the proportion is appropriate. There's no correlation. We didn't say that with more money from the Jockey Club, we would need more money. Why are you putting in $2 million? How does this cost compare with other events? Mr. Ray Chan is comparing the events in the outlying islands and Sha Tin. It's not the publicity fee is not high compared with other districts. This is just a financial budget. We hope to put in $2 million for community and community involvement and publicity. If we don't need to spend all this money, then you know, we would use a value for money approach. I think we have to deal with public expectation. Thank you, Chairman. Sha Tin is the most populated district in Hong Kong. And under this signature project scheme, we have to educate the public and promote our work. In other words, we need to let as many people know about it as possible. The district officer said, we are only reserving $2 million and we won't have to spend it all. I think it's reasonable to reserve more money since we have a lot of residents. Mr. Albert Chen, fifth round, 1 minute. I want to follow up on the viewing deck. The design plan is rather misleading. During high tides, the water level would almost cover up the entire area in sand. I don't think we should introduce more concrete buildings on the beach. A lot of beaches would build wooden decks instead of concrete decks. Hong Kong people love to put up concrete structures in natural settings. It's the same in country parks and beaches. It's horrible because these concrete buildings would destroy the natural views. Would you consider using natural wood as the material instead of concrete? Vice Chairman, thank you very much. This viewing deck is actually not located on the beach. Maybe you weren't here when we explained it. If you are familiar with Mui Wo, you should know that this area is connected to the bridge where a lot of sludge are, and there are a lot of rubbish at that area. So based on the topography, we came up with this idea of a viewing deck. It's not located on the beach. In terms of material, I think we can look into the possibilities. It's something we can enhance in our future designs. Mr. Ray Chan, fifth round, 1 minute. I don't intend to go into another debate with the government on whether we need such a high budget for publicity. For $100 million, spending $2 million makes sense. And I wanted to know what the publicity initiatives consist. You don't have to give me an answer, or else we will have a debate forever. You spent $50 million for Sheng Mun River, and you spent $2 million on publicity. Compared with other projects, is this appropriate? I think we should do a comparison among all 18 districts. Some districts might even have more than one signature project. I think they gave an answer already. It's comparable to other districts. Ms. Claudia Mo, fourth round, 1 minute. For the Silver Mine Bay projects, I'd like to know about the figures. There will be 13 female toilet cubicles, and for changing rooms, there will be 12 for female and 11 for males. Is that correct? So my point is that you are not being realistic with these intended numbers. Were those figures I give correct? Yes, those figures are right. So it shows that you are unrealistic. You only have 12 female cubicles compared with 11 male cubicles. There will be long queues for women. Mr. Lee, I understand that the more cubicles we have, the better, but the area is limited. We have increased the number of female cubicles by 71%. Ms. Claudia Mo, your time's up. He answered your question many, many times, and you've asked the same question twice. So this is meaningless. If you simply don't like his answer, and if you feel that there should be more female cubicles, and I understand, but you've been repeating yourself, I hope you won't repeat it a third time. Mr. Lan Kuo-hung, fifth round, 1 minute. I just want to know the number of lockers that will be provided. They can be used by both men and women. How many lockers will there be? Mr. Lee? They will be shared by men and women, right? The total number of lockers. Thank you very much. In our projects, we have no plans for extra lockers. But we will relay Mr. Leung's view. So you are not planning to introduce lockers, or you have no money for them? We have not reserved any funds for lockers. Are there any lockers at the moment? No. That's the question I asked, but you only answered the question partly, so I don't know. I didn't know whether it's my fault. So that's the problem. you know, we have to pay stores to rent lockers. I think you don't have to go any further. I think there's a need for lockers. We need lockers. Mr. Albert Chan, sixth round, 1 minute. Chairman, I asked whether the facilities are intended for the music festival. I was referring to enclosure 3, annex 3, the diagram in color. I cannot really see where the deck is, but apparently the deck Ms. Chow was referring to is different from the one I was looking at. So for the concrete recreational space, this is it this the round structure? No, I'm talking about the structure in the middle of the beach with the roof. That's a new structure, right? That's not the viewing deck, right? Yes, of course. Is this a new concrete structure? That's not the viewing deck. We have a concrete pile already, and we simply enhance it and widen it by 1 meter. Are you going to increase the depth by 1 meter? So the depth will be increased by 1 meter. Can you use wood in terms of wood instead of concrete? This is something we will consider in our design. Mr. Ray Chan, sixth round, 1 minute. Thank you, Chairman. According to the paper, pending our approval, the construction will start at the end of this year and completed by 2017. I'd like to know where our progress is. Can we avoid lighting systems manufactured in the mainland? Can we use some locally made or import products? We have a lot of concerns recently. I will come up with a motion requesting not to use some parts from the mainland. Who can answer this question? We have to wait for the FC's approval. So tendering has not started yet. But you should have it done by the end of this year, right? We have to wait and see. We are not sure yet.
In relation to Mr. Ray Chan's question, we'll follow our established procedure. And we have been using the same criteria. So you can't, in the tender document, exclude certain items or certain material from certain area because you're restricted by WTO terms. Yes, we can only specify the specification. We cannot specify a certain brand or exclude a certain brand. All right, this will be your last question. So it's not really the case that it will start at the end of the year because that is so stated in the document. Mr. Wong? Well, if funding approval is given today, we will start preparing for the tender document. If everything goes smoothly, then works can commence at the end of this year. If there are no hiccups in the tender exercise, how long will it take for the tender exercise to complete? 2-3 months? Normally, we will give 6 weeks, and then there will be vetting, 3 to 4 weeks. So if you get funding approval today, we don't have the finalized version of the tender document yet. So we will need another 2 months to finalize it. So with funding approval today, you're now saying it will take 2 months, that is end of September, for tender document to be available, and then there's 6 weeks, so in November, the tender exercise will finish, and then you will decide who the tender, the contract will go to, and that will be a different term, so good luck, because there will be a change of term in the district council. This session will end at 1:10. I'll have to chair food and environmental hygiene panel at 2:00. That will last for 2.5 hours. If you want to deal with this before 1:10, well, it's not for me to say, to decide whether we will have an extension of 15 minutes. If you want division, if you want to move at 37, then I don't know how long it will take. Well, I will give a minute to Mr. Leung and 1 minute to you, Mr. Chen, and then you won't deal with the 37A, yes? Well, there is no discrimination. No discrimination against, Christopher Chung. In this council, who uses mainland Chinese mobile phone because of the poor quality? He uses one. I don't discriminate against Chinese products, but they are of an inferior quality you're honest with me, show me your mobile phone. Well, if it's made in China, it just means it's manufactured in China for someone else. For some products, it's no surprise that you use Chinese product. I know about the WHO terms. Mr. Ray Chen, after 1 minute, we'll put it to a vote. Well, my 37A motion is not to stop the project from using lighting systems manufactured on the mainland. Well, you know what I mean. I want to make myself clear for the administration's consideration. When tender documents are returned, if they are lighting system from the mainland, please step up your monitoring of safety and quality. And of course, you say to me that you will treat all products the same, whether it is from Europe or not, but you understand our concern. That means that if it's Chinese products, they will have to scrutinize it under magnifying glass. Yes. I will put this to a vote if there are no other questions. Those in favour of PWSC bracket 2015-16 number 32, please raise your hands. I claim a division. The bell will ring for 5 minutes. Let me remind members that the voting is on PWSC bracket 2015-16 number 32. There are 8 items, 8 projects in this item. However, 454RO and 285RS have been separated from the others, but this vote is on all 8 items under this number. Voting begins. Before I announce result, members, please check your votes. Voting stops, result displayed. 25 for, 0 against, 0 abstention. I declare the proposal passed. We will start with the third item at 6:45. Thank you.